Wow, sino ang nag-enjoy, nag-bless sa word ni Lord last month? And I believe everyone is excited to hear God's word today. And let us welcome our messenger of God. And Ate Rubilin Acojedo. Come on, let's clap or give our best clap. Ate Rubilin, this is our seed. And whatever you declare, we receive and perceive it.
Sige po, let's pray for our seed, for the seed. Lord, salamat po sa imo, kaayo sa amon mga buhay. Thank you, Lord, for your goodness and faithfulness. And salamat din, Lord, sa mga kaanakan mo na nag-support sa Nina Ministry. Adi po, in the seed, I pray na whatever the assignment of this seed, granted in the name of Jesus. I pray, Lord, na ini siya na seed, magatubo gayod kag maka-harvest in the sun. A harvest of souls, harvest of miracles, and harvest of finances. And this would use, Panginoon, for the advancement of your kingdom. Bless Soul Harvest family. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, once again, good afternoon. Pwede ba na palakpakan natin ang mga nakapagtapos pa lang sa aton Breaking Free? Adis in the Sugad. Kaway-kaway naman dyan, ang mga nakapag-encounter pa lang. Ay, nakapag-breaking free pa lang. Wow, mga pinalaya. Sige, palakpakan gihapon natin, Sinda. Grabe no, every time na may encounter, na-excite gayud kita kasi may experience din inda kung ano yung na-experience natin. And malipay ka kita na God is really busy changing lives, no? Damo kita san kilala na dati, ano lang, inan ordinary lang, but sa nakilala gayud din da si Lord, naging extraordinary. And amo man inan katakin mo. Kaya sa mga nasa one-to-one pa lang, tuloy lang. And one day, makita guide namon ka muna, ima-encounter nyo din si Lord. And this afternoon, padayon kita sa aton series, I Am Committed. Pwede ba na i-remind mo, anay, inan katakin mo, sabihin mo sa'yo, you are committed. Praise God. So, sa November, amin na naging topic naton. And agabi mismo ako na fire up gayod and maayo na maipadayon sa nina month sa December, right? So, first Sunday, we talk about commitment to the Master. Alam nyo ba na mahalaga gayod ang commitment? Sa usad na work or sa usad na pagaklase, sugod sana, and business, importante yung commitment. Pag ikaw, estudyante ka, nag-commit ka gayud magklase 8 to 5, mga assignments, projects, that's part para makapagtapos ka kag one day mag-igwa ka san maayo na trabaho. That's commitment. And amo man sa aton mga nagatrabaho, 'di ba, pag nag-sign ka san contract or amina inan nag-apply ka na hire ka, your commitment is to magpasok from 8 to 5, 'di ba? 8 hours work gayud ina siya kag amo man na yung magtrabaho ka para makompensate ka. That's commitment. And gina-honor gayud ina siya ni Lord din as we work din sa secular. And amo man sa business, di ba pag may business ka, your commitment is to satisfy your customer. Di ba sa mga businessmen and mga business pa lang, usad gayud din na commitment naton. Na i-satisfy ang aton customer. And tama yon na in order for that work to be successful, importante ang commitment. And amo man sa aton, sa aton Ginoo, importante na una, nag-commit ka gayud sa Master. Mahirap magpadayon or mag-next level sa maturity, di ba sa Christ-like maturity, ministry, or nano pa man, kundili ka gayud una nag-commit sa Master. That's so impossible. Kasi may mga times na pwede ka gayud makapoy, pag-serve, pag nano pa man ang imo ginahimo. Kasi nga ni, our strength comes from the Lord gayud. Inisyata na ginahimo ini, it involves sa spiritual gayud na aspect. So, amo man na, kung adi ka sugad, I encourage you na kung first timer ka man or kakakadi mo pa lang, I encourage you to commit muna to the Master. Importante yung relationship natin kay Lord. Amen. And sa nakilala natin si Lord, of course, nagkaigwa kita ng spiritual family. We are committed to our church. Diba, sino dito yung blessed ka kasi naandito ka sa Soul Harvest? Ako personally, na-blessed gayod kasi the moment na nakilala ko ba si Lord, may nag-alaga na sa leader, Di ba, may nag-follow up, may nag-disciple, kaya ina nag-grow, nag-mature. And importante po iyon na you, ina, may church gayud na nakokonekan ka or may church na nag-alaga sa imo. That's one of the blessing din pag nag-commit kita gayud sa aton master. And kaya I encourage you na maghanap gayud sa church nyo kung din ka makommit because that is so important. And along the way, di ba, inan, kapag ka-growing na gayud yung relationship mo kay Lord, adaman gayud dida yung Christ-like maturity. Yung goal san maturity, kaya ano kay we aim to grow, we aim to mature is for us to be like Christ. So dili man gayud eksakto na parehas gayud kay Kristo ba na inan, dili man pano, may mga attributes pa no siya na dili man gayud naton makuha. Parehas an all-knowing. Di ba, dili ka man all-knowing. Dili man kita all-knowing na aram naton ang tanan. So dili na ginpasa ni Lord sa aton. And ang man omnipresent, dili ka man all the time present. Dili na siya. But yung mga, yung character na gusto gayud ni Lord maduplicate sa aton as we commit to Christ-like maturity. And amo man na, dili lang kita gin-save ni Lord, but gintagaan gayud niya kita sa an opportunity to serve in our ministry. Diba, inan, sabi dito sa last Sunday na, kahit nano man ang imo talents or skills, or kundiin ka man ang ministry so God, we are serving the Lord. Only the Lord. Kaya dili ang imo minister head, or kung sino pa man ang imo ginaanuhan, but si Lord gayud. Kaya, importante na we are faithful. We found ourselves faithful kundi in kaman ginbutang. And this month of December, ito yung pag-uusapan natin, yung fifth level of maturity. And that is a commitment to Christ's mission or Jesus' mission. Jesus' mission is my mission. Amen. And when we say mission, pag nababatian nato ng mission, what comes to your mind? Diba? And usually, iguan hiri mo on. It's a task assigned or ano ba? It's a specific task or assignment na himo on. Diba like sa mga companies, igo ba gasindan mission and vision? Da sa schools, igo sinda sina na inan, pag nahimo mo ina, it will impact the betterment of the company. Diba? It will impact the betterment of your school. Kasad man ina dida na pa naton. It's good na kapag ka na-accomplish mo na, that's temporary. May temporary reward, of course. Pero sa aton, as a child of God, God gave us the mission, the great mission. And it will impact, it will really impact our lives. Diba? It will impact your family. It will impact the people around you. And that is the mission that God has entrusted to us. Sabi sa John 17, verse 18. Sabi da, ang prayer ni Jesus, sabi da, Jesus prayed to the Father, in the same way that you gave me a mission in the world, I gave them a mission in the world. Inanad them na ginasabi niya, tayo yun, yung mga anak ng Lord, the follower of Christ. And context na na verse, he's talking about yun, the vision, the mission na gin-interest niya sa iya mga disciples. Kaya nga ni, sa aton din, nano kayo nag-spread out yung gospel, kahit wala na didi si Lord, kasi may mga true followers siya na naghimo sa mission man niya. Amen? Kaya nakaabot diri ang gospel, kaya nagkaigwasan churches and all, kasi may disciple, may mga true follower na nag-commit gayud sa vision, may nag-commit sa nina mission. So that's the prayer of God sa atong tanan na we will, His mission will be our mission. This is not the mission of the soul harvest. This is the mission, the great mission of God na gin-entrust din sa aton. And His mission is also continuum or continuous. Dili, sana mag-continue gayud yung vision ni Lord from generation to generation until such time that we meet God. No, it's really a journey gayud and vision and mission ni Lord. So okay. So as body of Christ, His mission is also our mission. Well, Lord, an akong family, gabi dili pa nagabag-o, an akong mga an schools and akong katrabahuan and usa din na mahirap talaga mamuot kapag kadili ka una na muot kay Kristo. And we cannot do that apart from God, apart from loving Him. Kasi, yan din yung very hugot ni Lord. Diba, why He came here on earth? Because He loved us so much. Diba, John 3:16, namuot gayud siya sa aton, kaya nga He abandoned heaven. Naghaligayud siya, He abandoned His comfort, He abandoned everything para lang kadiun ka kag iligtas. What a blessing ba, a big gift ba sa aton tanan. And amo man, as we do the mission, importante kaayo yung kamuot gayud natin kay Lord. Sana we do it with love. We are motivated by love. Amin kayo ng mga fuel sa aton to reach out the lost. It's our love for God. So amo man dili sa aton, where we are doing this, nag-i-invite kita, di man nagdi-disciple, gabi na nag-one-to-one sa imo, nag-atsyaga, mag-bisita, mag-pray, because namuot gayud kita una kay Lord. And si Lord, baga, He really loves souls. He is in a habit of winning souls, di ba? Amo gayud din ang iya, the main purpose, amin ang heartbeat niya yung mga kalag. The heart of God beats for people, beats for you, di ba? And for me. So sabi sa 1 John 4:19, we love because He first loved us. Amen. Diba, namuot kita kasi namuot una sa aton ang Diyos. Amin ang greatest love man, naging pakita niya din. Diba, sabi niya sa Romans 5:8 na, while we were still sinners, gabi makasalanon ka palang, namatay na si Lord para sa imo. Amin niya, but God demonstrate His own love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Romans 5:8. So, isa din na, what a great love na ginpakita niya when He died on the cross for us. So, isa din na, we can do the mission only by loving Him. And sabi sa Matthew 22, verse 37, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul, and with all your strength. The first and foremost commitment that we ought to sign up for is obedience to great commandment. So amo gayod na, and we cannot go through the great commission without the great commandment. That is loving God with all your heart, with everything. Praise God kung nagatrabaho kay tanaw, naga-business ka, but above all, sana an mamuot ka gayod kay Lord. Because amo gayod na very purpose na no, kaging create din kita niya. To love Him. And sabi niya sa John 14:15, Jesus said, if you love me, you will obey my commandments. Diligay din nakikita, no? In our obedience with God, nakikita kay kung namuot ka mang gayud kay Lord. Kasi madali lang magsabi na I love God. Pero nakikita siya sa obedience natin. When we obey His commands, didi nakikita how much we love God. How much do you love God? Nakikita ina sa imo obedience sa iya. And usan man din nag-command niya is, the Great Commission. So every day, importante gayud na gina-ask mo, no, na, Lord, fill me today with your love. Fill me today with your grace. Fill me today with your unlimited love. Kasi amo nga nina na God will use us para guide sa nina mga tao. And pandawa, the more we love God naman, we will learn His ways. Diba, the more na nakikilala mo si Lord sa imo buhay, the more na naaraman mo ang iya ways, ang iya character, ang iya ways. And sabi niya sa Matthew 11:29, He said, learn from me for I am gentle and humble in heart. Gabi si Lord noon na as we follow Him gayod, as we grow our love to Him, nagiging ganun din tayo, gentle and humble in heart. Amen. Diba, yung character ni Christ na duduplicate sa aton buhay. But the more we love God, the more na nakakilala natin siya, mas nag-manifest ang character niya sa aton buhay. Though, dili mang gani agad-agad, but you are in the process na as you follow God, as you love Him. Ada na gay din na. And sabi sa Matthew 9:35, Jesus went through all towns and villages. Gabi na, that's His ways then, as he do the mission, He went through all towns and villages, teaching in their synagogues, preaching the good news of the kingdom, healing the disease and sickness. Amin ang ginhimo niya, it's intentional. Diba? Ginpakita gayud niya paano siya mamuot sa mga tao. He went through all the villages and towns. So amo man sa ato, no, as we do the mission, dili pwede na ada ka lang sa iyo balay. Diba? Dili pwede na dili lang kita sa church. Church is not it is not exclusive. Diba? Nakita-kita lang. No, the church is designed to reach out for people na wara pagayud sa iya. We are designed to reach out for people now na nakakilala na gayud kita kay Lord. And amin ang ginhimo niya, healing the sick, that's his ministry talaga. It's for people. Amo talaga ang heart niya to minister to the people, to heal the sick, to open the eyes of the blind. Amin na siya iya ministry. And in verse 36, sabi that when he saw the crowds, he had compassion on them because they were harassed and helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. No, sa nagkatugayod siya sa towns and villages, dito niya nakita. Kaya nga ni Saturn din, you really need to go through kay kung diin ka man ginapakadto ni Lord. Even to your family. Makita mo gayod, makikita na damo na tao yung harassed and helpless. Diba, yung mga kaklase mo, gay patawa-tawa lang ina, pero depressed na gali. Diba, longing for love. Pero dili talang gayod nakikita sa aton mataba, but inan yung spiritual eyes gayod na dapat ma-open. So, they are harassed and helpless like sheep without a shepherd. Aminan, pagka-describe ni Jesus. Kaya sana amo man kita, as his follower, as part of the body of Christ, sana we see what Jesus saw. Diba sabi niya, he saw the crowds and they are harassed and helpless. Lord, inanamin ang prayer nato na, Lord, give me your eyes that see beyond. Diba, pag nakikita natin gabi, may kotse, mayaman, well compensated, promoted, manager, pero ang kamatuudan gayud sina na they are hopelessly lost. Diba, they really need Jesus in the life. Amo man sa atin, syempre. Na inan, makita mo ba in the spiritual realm gayud na they are dying, they really need Jesus in their lives ba? Kahit gabing kakapursu san mga yaman, dili lang gyapon na satisfy. Kasi wala man gayud didan satisfaction sa mga material things. So nano pa, sabi niya dida na sa nakita niya ang crowd, nagkaigwagad siya san compassion. And amo man kita no, sana we feel what Jesus felt. Sa nakita niya mga kaklase ng crowds, posible na mga estudyante, mga working, mga businessmen, sa nakita niya na nag-igugad siya ng compassion. Di ba yung compassion, amoy na siya, mag-push ba sa im, or yung kaluoy na dili na nakaluoy ka lang, pero yung may hihimuon ka gayon. So sana iguman kita sinan pamatsyago na every time nakikita mo ang imong kapamilya, or ang imong mga kaklase, igwa ka man pamatsyago na i-reach out gayud sinda. Because that compassion ba ang mag-push gayud sa imo para i-win sinda. And nano pa, we do what Jesus did. Aminan, nangyari na san time na nakita niya na dida, naghimo gayud siya san way, para gayud ini siya ng mga taong maligtas din. So sana amo man kita na himuon gayud naton yung part naton, kung diin man ang imong mission field, so God, estudyante ka man, ada ka sa campus, do your best gayud to carry the mission na gin-entrust sa aton ni Lord, or sa workplaces, that's your mission field. So kung wara pa, pray ka gayud sana no, na makita naton kung ano yung nakita ni Jesus. Mabatsyagan natin kung ano na batsyagan niya, kagmahimo gayud natin, because sabi nga ni Lord, we can do even greater. Diba? We can do even greater kay kung ano pa man ang iya ginhimo, because we are His disciples, His follower. And okay, number three is, as we continue loving God and knowing His ways, we will live for Him. So the more na nakakilala mo si Lord sa imo buhay, the more na aaraman mo yung plano niya, and siya gayod, maabot ang time na you will really live for Him. Sabi di, loving Him sincerely and learning His ways consistently will empower us to become salt and light in this world. We now live with a purpose. So amo man sa aton tanan no, na pag nakilala mo gayod sa buhay mo si Lord, God will really give you purpose. Kahit man sa akon din, dati baganura lang, go with the flow. Pero sa nakilala ko ba si Lord sa akong buhay, it makes sense. ang tanan na bagay, kung ano yung, kung ano kay Adi ako, Lord. What is the reason kay nano kay Adi ako, so God, what's my purpose? And na-discover ko, gay, din sa nakilala ko si Lord. Now, the mission will give, God and the mission will give you purpose in your life. So, nanon purpose to become the salt and the light of this world. Matthew 5:13-14, adada nakabutang, na pag sa nakilala natin si Lord, nagkinabuhay kita sa iya, you will become the salt. Diba? Pag unsalt, we preserve relationships. We treasure relationships. That's the ano. The essence man's unsalt. Gayod na, inan, we don't cut relationships. Kitaan, nag-promote logod sa relationships. Kag nag-influence. Nano yung influence na ihahatag naton or ipapasa naton? That's the influence of God to our lives. Pero minsan, na, dili, kahit dili ka na nga mag-share ba, so nano ginginhimo ni Lord sa imo, but your life, di ba, your life will speak about Jesus. Kahit dili mo na ba, inan, di ka na ba mag-share, pero makikita pa lang sa imo lifestyle, sa imo pag-obey kay Lord, na nakikita gayon, nag-glorify siya sa imo life. Okay. And na pa, light. We provide illumination and give direction. So amo man ang aton buhay, as God gave us direction, amo man ang aton part, nano ang part natin is to lead them pakatugayod kay Lord, to find the way pinaagi sa aton buhay. And kita din yung magahatag san, kapawa ba sa mga tao na nagakinabuhay pa sa kadulum. Di ba, God will really use your life. Sige lang, kahit kung ada ka pa sa level na nag-mature ka pa lang, ada ka pa lang sa church, nag-grow, that's part of the process. Pero one day, ako nagatuod na God will really use us para gayud sa iya glory, para sa iya mission. Para sa iya mission. And sabi din sa Matthew 5:16, in the same way, let your light shine before men, that they may see your good deeds and praise God, praise your Father in heaven. So amo na makikita gayud, as we shine for God's glory, makikita din ni nasan iba na tao, and they will really praise God. Ma-encourage sinda sa life mo, kung paano ka ina nag-stand. Aram mo, maging didi din, it's hard to stand in this corrupt generation ba. But I believe na by the grace of God, kaya tagayod, because as we mission, kaupod tagayod si Lord. So kaya mo gayod to stand in your campuses, to bring light to people. Kaya gayod natin because God is with us. And last is, nano ba yung mission, inina mission na gin-entrust sa ato ni Lord? So our God's mission and our mission is to seek and save what was lost, to win the lost. That is primary reason nano kay nagkadig siya gayud sa kalibutan, to save us, to save people. That's his mission. And now that we are his disciple, his followers, God will use us as instrument, diba, to save the lost, to seek and save the lost people. Gabi sinuman lang kita, no, it's really a great privilege ba na mag-commit sa mission, kasi sino ka man lang nagamiton kagayod ni Lord, na we are one sinner lang, sinners lang din. Pero amin na, nagrasyahan, kaya adisugad ginagamit na ni Lord. And sabi niya da sa, ito yung great commission ni Lord sa aton in Matthew 28:18-20. Sabi da, then Jesus came to them and said, all authority in heaven and earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. Surely I will be with you to the very end of the age. Paano natin sinda i-reach out by going to them? Di ba, to go, sabi nga ni, go and make disciples. So, paano, ang process man is discipleship gayod. That's the key para inan makakilala kag mag-grow pa yung relationship ni that one day, sinda naman ang pagagamito ni Lord. That's his commission, and ayaw ka handal because God is giving us the authority gayod. Ayaw ka kahandal kung di ka maaaram mag-English, di ka maaaram mag-Tagalog, Bisaya lang galing. So, ayaw ka handal, kay the Lord is with us. Amin ang promise niya that surely I am with you always to the very end of the age. Ina na promise, para lang gayon sa mga nag-go and make disciples. That's the context. So, ayo kahandal kung pagkantoon ka man ni Lord sa Iraq, sa Iran, sa Mindanao, or kung diin man na area, or da lang sa imo kapitbahay, na kaaway nyo, okay lang yun na, because the Lord is with us naman. And He will, I mean, never leave us nor forsake us. And in 2 Corinthians 5:20, sabi da, we are Christ ambassadors or representative. And God is using us to speak to you. Sabi di, we urge you, sabi ni Paul, we urge you as through Christ Himself we're pleading with you. Be reconciled with God. So this is our purpose then, na inan yung mga tao na wara pa kay Lord, ma-reconcile gayud sa iya. Reconciliation with God. God will use us ba as bridge, as gap, para sa nina mga tao na makakilala gayud sinda kay Lord. Kasi amo man, ang very purpose din ni Lord, na makilala natin siya sa aton buhay. So, we will testify, no, sabi di, we become His ambassadors or representatives, testifying to the loss, the transforming power of God, the good news of salvation that we have personally experienced. So, ma-testify gayud ba kita by kung ano yan yung na-experience mo, the power of the good news that na nag-save gayud sa aton. And yun. So, your life will be a living testimony gayud, how God is powerful ba na mag-change san usad na tao. Kaya don't be afraid na mag-share kahit na i-mission man imo kapitbahay or kung sino pa man dida, because the Lord is really with us. And tandaan naton that we are made for a mission. We were made for a mission. May mission ka talaga didi kasi si Lord gayud an nag-intend na inan mabuhay ka ba. Kasi tandaan mo na si Lord ang naghatag san buhay. Di ba ginggamit lang ang imo nanay kag tatay. Pero si Lord gayud an may matindi na plano sa aton buhay ba. And that plan gayud is to be used for His glory. God will really use us. And the word mission, ang Latin word sana is for sending. Kaya nga ni, God will really send us pakadto sa mga tao na dili pa gayud nakakilala sa iya. And gusto ko tapuson ini na preaching sa nina passage sa Acts 20 verse 24. Sabi sa author D, but my life is worth nothing to me unless I use it for finishing the work assigned me by the Lord Jesus, the work of telling others the good news about wonderful grace of God. Gabi no, na, and then, our life is meaningless kapag dili mo gayud siya ginpagamit kay Lord. Life is without purpose kapag dili mo gayud siya, inan, dili mo na araman ko na ano talaga yung true meaning of life. Diba? Inan, it's nothing. Kaya kung dili mo aram kanon agad yung assignment mo didi sa earth. And sabi dida, our great assignment is to tell others the good news about the wonderful grace of God. Katahum lang no na inan, through our life, many souls will be saved. Many souls will be discipled through your life. Na inan, maapikihan ka ba? Ate, salamat gayud sa imo life. Na pinaagi sa imo buhay na restore ang akong dreams, ang akong purpose, dahil nakilala ko si Lord. Though glory to God, pero katahong lang gayud sana no, na gamitin kita ni Lord para sa mga tao na dili pa nakakilala sa iya. So as we stand and ponder the word, let's pray and let's ask God na as we commit to Him, gamit yung life gayud naton is magamit para sa iya purpose. Because amo talaga an reason kay nano kay ging create kita niya. So let's pray and ponder the word. Lord, we really praise you and we thank you, Lord, for your commitment to us. Salamat, Lord, na wa kami Dios na committed gayud na kamut-an kami. Pakita mo na, Lord, when you died on the cross for our sin. And thank you, Lord, for thank you for that great love na pinaagi din sana kami na save, nakakilala sa imo, kag na-restore yung matahong na plano mo sa amon buhay. And tonight, Lord, nag-pray kami, na tanan kami, Lord, magamit mo gayon para sa mga tao na dili pa nakakilala sa imo. Some of us, anamon family, wara pa dida sa imo, na mga kaklase, workmates of God or mga amon mga kakilala. Lord, I pray na kami tanan, Panginoon, maging hands mo, maging ears mo, God, maging mouthpiece mo, Lord, to share your word. And I pray, Lord, na kami tanan, makita gayud namon kung ano yung nakita mo when you saw the crowd, Lord. Help us to have that eyes na parehas gayud sa imo. And help us, Lord, to have that heart, God, na parehas sa imo man, na full of compassion. I pray na kami as we go to our mission field, I pray that we will be driven by your love. We will be driven by that compassion, Lord, na mahimo gayud kung ano yung ginapahimo mo man sa amo, God. Lord, I pray na sanina mga masunod na adlaw, buligi kami, Lord, na makeri gayud ina siya na mission, and that is to seek and save the lost, O God. Lord, I pray na kami tanan, Panginoon, pagagamiton mo sa amon family, sa amon community, sa amon city, maging sa amon country, and to the whole world, O God, to the ends of the earth, Lord, to share and to spread your goodness, God, to spread the gospel, Panginoon, that you have, that we have known, Lord, sa nakakilala kami sa imo. Thank you, Lord, for the opportunity to be used for your kingdom, O God. I pray na kami tanan, Lord, magalakaton gayud, Panginoon, carrying the vision, the mission, na ginpasa mo gayud din sa amon, O God. Thank you, Lord. We praise you, we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Sige, pwede na kita mag-ingkod. Grabe, praise God sa gin-interest ni Lord sa aton na mission. Amen. Si Pastora Rubes, nag-mission man nina sa Uson. Diba, nagkaupod niyan iba na leaders. And praise God, grabe na sinun maghuna na nag-first anniversary na ang Sul Uson. Amen. Diba, dahil lang sa may compassion, dahil sa may heart na mag-send, magkadto para lang sa mga lost souls. Amen. So, siguro nakita niyo sa Asher's table. So, ini siya is mission offerings. So, kung igoha mo sa heart na inan makabulig sa mga nagamission, so, nagamission kita sa Milagros, sa Placer, sa Uson. So, igoha kita ng opportunity na makapagtanom. Grabe na inan, siguro gusto nag-desire ka na inan makapag-upod, makapag-mission man, pero igoha ka ng opportunity na makapag-seed. And I believe na dili lang just na bless ang imo seed, but also dili lang just na bless, but yung may makakilala gayud kay Lord, amin ang pinakamatahom na blessing kagbalik ni Lord sa imo. So as we give, inan isabay naton ang mission offerings naton. So kung gusto nyo mag mission offerings, mag seed, so igo kita sa ushers, sa mga ushers, pwede po kamo magngayo. So come on, let's prepare our tithes and offerings and also our mission offerings. Come on, let's pray. Lord, we praise you, O God. Thank you, Lord, na nag-interest ka sa amon, Lord, sa mission mo. Lord, sino man lang kami, but God, thank you na, Lord, yung magamit mo para makakilala ang iba sa imo, O God. Lord, send us, Lord. We are willing, Lord, na ipadara mo sa amon friends, ipadara mo sa amon family, kag sino pa man, Lord, we are willing na makapag-share sa imo word, O God. And Lord, I pray na ini na amon mga offerings magabring gayud sa more souls, Lord, na makakilala sa imo. We pray, Lord, for your favor na maskin diin man kami sa ang mga nagaklase, Lord, nagatrabaho, Lord, maskin adi lang sa balay, we pray, Lord, for compassion, O God. We pray na makapag-mission kami mismo sa amon trabaho, sa amon school, or sa amon panimalay, O God. We praise you, Lord. We glorify you. In Jesus' name, amen.